In this video, we'll compare Node.js with Bun and Dina using latest versions available at this moment. I decided to update this video to include native APIs that Bun provides, like those for Postgres, S3, and others. In the first simple test, we'll measure latency, throughput, availability, as well as saturation of each application. The second test is a bit more interesting, and I included a Postgres database and a new native Postgres API provided by Bun. I run all my tests on NBS using the same production-ready infrastructure that I use to run real applications that serve real customers. Alright, let's go ahead and run the first test. Here we just return hard-coded objects back to the client when it sends a GET request to the /API/users endpoint. You can find the source code in my public GitHub repo. The entire test took around 1.5 hours, and I just compressed it to a few minutes while editing. So here we have P90 latency for the GET request. Then we have throughput or requests per second each application can handle. CPU usage. In this case, I use average CPU usage of both pods running for each application. Then I have memory usage, availability, which is the error rate. And finally, since we run these applications in Kubernetes, we need to measure CPU throttling. This happens when the pod tries to use more CPU than defined in the pod spec. Also, I use standard library for the Node.js to create a web server, and I do the same for the Bun as well as for the Dino runtime, and they all return exactly the same hard-coded objects in this first test. So let me run this test for one more minute, and we'll go over each graph one by one at the end. Alright, first we have requests per second. Node.js only reached 48,000 requests per second, while Dina reached 62,000 requests per second, and Bun around 85,000. Just a quick reminder, Bun is based on the Zig programming language, Dina is based on Rust, and Node.js is based on the V8 JavaScript engine. Next, we have latency, and lower the latency, the better. Node.js has the highest latency among these three, and Bun looks like the best performing application in this test. Since I use native libraries for this test, both Dina and Bun can use all optimizations they can using their runtimes to optimize their performance in this test. Next, we have CPU usage. Memory usage. Take a note of Bun's memory usage. In this test, it has the smallest memory footprint, but it will change in the next test. Then we have availability. And finally, CPU throttling. So this would conclude the first test, where Bun clearly performs better than any other application. Now, let's see what happens when we start to use a database in the next test. In the second test, a client sends a POST request to each application. Then each application parses the request body and saves that item to a relational database. In this case, latest Postgres 17.2. This video was inspired by claims that Bun has native APIs for common operations such as Postgres, S3, and others. So I used latest native API, which doesn't really have a good documentation. At this point, even the examples they provide don't work. I found a solution in the GitHub. So it's definitely very early for this native Postgres driver, but I still wanted to test it. Actually, I tested Bun's native S3 driver as well for uploading images to S3 bucket. And it really performed very well compared to standard AWS SDK v3. At this point, there is no way to adjust the connection pool size for the Bun Postgres driver. And it looks like they hardcoded 10 connections per Bun instance. So in this case, I have 2 instances and total of 20 connections. That's 10 connections per 1 CPU, which I think is good enough. Other applications dynamically scale the connection pool based on the load. And I set 250 connection limit for each instance, totaling 500. In this test, I also internally instrumented each application with Prometheus metrics, and I measured post latency from the client side. All right, let me run this test for one more minute. First, we have requests per second, and Bun again performed very well in this test, reaching almost 18,000 requests per second. We basically use a JavaScript Zig wrapper, and since I use the native Bun API, it can be optimized very well compared to other applications that use third-party libraries. Next, we have overall post request latency, and Bun once again has the lowest latency. Next is the database latency. And we have memory usage. Now, there is a big problem with Bun native Postgres implementation. It has a memory leak. You can see that application multiple times reached the limit and Kubernetes killed it with OM kill error and restarted it. So my conclusion is that native Bun APIs like Postgres and S3, which I tested, provide huge performance benefits, but based on my test, they're not ready for production yet. Also, since they're part of the source code, they will always lack some new features that external databases and object stores provide. But this is the only way to optimize those JavaScript runtimes. As you can see, in Dina, if you use third-party libraries not optimized for Rust, it's going to be even slower than just using a plain vanilla Node.js runtime. I'm not sure if this is a scalable approach with these JavaScript runtimes. They would need to develop and maintain native APIs to perform better than Node.js. Let me know what do you think. I have other benchmarks covering Redis, Memcache, and databases. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.